On today's episode of You Asked, what even is local dimming? Who's gonna have the mini LED RGB TV to beat this year? And why is everyone so obsessed with brighter TVs? Welcome back to the channel, everyone. This is You Asked, the show where we answer your tech questions. If you've got something you wanna know, send your question to youasked@digitaltrends.com. And don't forget to tune into the show to see if your question has been selected. The first question comes from @weirdnamja, who says, why is everyone so obsessed with getting the brightest picture they can get? Is burning out your retina the new trend or what? We get this question every so often, but it warrants a quick answer. It's not that everyone's obsessed with a blindingly bright TV that's maxed out from edge to edge, but rather a bright TV means you have a better looking HDR, high dynamic range picture. So long as the TV has a local dimming feature and does a good job with it, that means the bright areas will be brighter and the darker areas remain dark, giving you a beautiful image that jumps off the screen. Throw in the advancements with color and brightness and TVs look better now than ever before. And actually, that kind of answers the next question from @KK77GELB25, which reads, can you explain to me what local dimming is? I have a 55-inch HISENSE U7N TV, but for some reason, I can't find good graphics settings. Default colors are way too washed out for the price I paid, and if I try raising contrast or saturation, then I can't see anything during dark scenes. Well, I'll start by saying we did a video about HISENSE settings we recommend with that exact TV model, actually, but I'm not gonna leave you hanging with just that, even though you should also check that video out. First thing, local dimming. It's kind of like it sounds. It allows the TV backlight to make local brightness adjustments instead of having the light shine through equally across the frame. When that happens, you get a flatter looking, less dynamic image. But with local dimming, you get different areas of light and dark, and those highlights in HDR can really stand out. Again, that's why we like bright TVs. That's also why you hear manufacturers boast about the amount of dimming zones in their TVs. The more zones you have, the more control of the contrast you can have throughout the image. Although, as someone I know often quotes, it's not the amount of dimming zones, but how you use them that matters. Have fun with that deep cut. I recommend setting the local dimming to high on your U7N. That should help with the contrast you're looking for. As for your color issue, it's interesting that you say the colors look washed. If anything, they're usually a little too juiced up or less accurate out of the box in standard mode. But also, maybe you like that extra bit of color. If you've put the TV into filmmaker mode to get more accurate creator-intended colors, maybe you're missing that extra punch. Or if you're in a bright room, maybe that ambient light is washing out the image a little bit. Either way, I'd recommend going into theater day and theater night modes and making some custom adjustments to see what you like best in different scenarios. If you're in a bright room during the day, turn the brightness up in theater day mode. Then in theater night mode, see what works best at night. Then you can go between those two and maybe filmmaker mode as well to find your ideal setup, whether it's day or night when you're watching. I'd recommend testing them with dark scenes as well. Okay, so this next question comes from Bruce Wayne. This one came straight to the You Asked inbox, so if Batman can take time out of his day or night to send a question in, you can too. The Cape Crusader himself says, nobody makes an 83-inch QD-OLED panel, so I'm leaning toward the LG C6H. For your information, the room I'm gonna put it in has shutters, so I don't need blinding brightness. My question is, what mini LED or micro RGB LED TV do you think might be a better option? Without actually testing, what's your gut feeling between LG, Samsung, and Sony as to who will have the best implementation of this technology? Whose colors will be as good or better than QD OLED? You see, I have a Sony X900H and LG G4. I'm completely happy with both TVs, but always felt like I was missing out on the QD OLED colors. I know the new 2.0 LG panel with the Gen 3 Alpha 11 processor is supposed to come really close, but I'm wondering about the new RGB LEDs. Well, if you've got Bruce Wayne money, you could just buy all the TVs and see which one works best. But if this is not the real Dark Knight, well, you might want to spend a little more conservatively. Honestly, like you said, I think the LG C6H is going to be a big winner. Now, transparently, I didn't get a chance to look at it myself at CES, but having seen the LG G5 a lot last year, an improved version of that panel is all I need to hear. As for the rest of what's coming, just based on the processing we've seen from them in the past, I think Sony is going to be extremely competitive with its RGB mini LED TV. The Bravia 9 remains incredible, and whatever Sony cooks up to top that is going to be very good and probably have its own twist on how the RGB tech is implemented. But I'll also say this, even though it sounds like you've got your mindset on those three brands, after seeing Dolby Vision 2 and knowing that Hisense and TCL TVs plan to support it probably sooner than the rest, just save room for those brands on your list as well, because I think their options are going to be stellar. And that leads us to the last question, or statement, from BigBro8439. He says, "I was an early adopter of HDR and Dolby Vision. As soon as I used it, though, I was very disappointed. Watching series like The Man in the High Castle or Game of Thrones was often far too dark. I even bought two new high-end OLED TVs, and that didn't give me enough brightness, as on my former 83-inch Sony A90J, the picture was still too dark. It's nice that we can watch it as the creator intended, but not if all details disappear into a black blob. Now Dolby comes with Dolby Vision 2, actually admitting that the original Dolby Vision was too dark for almost all TVs. To enjoy this, we, the consumer, will now have to buy new TVs that are able to show Dolby Vision 2. Well, I totally get your frustration, big bro, and I'll also admit that I've been pretty spoiled in my Dolby Vision viewing. We work in a room with controlled light that can be turned completely off if we want, and we put eyes on some of the best TVs you can buy. So while a lot of content does come across darker than others, it's never been too dark for me, but that's easy to say while viewing on a flagship TV. If you recently bought a TV for Dolby Vision, only for it now to not be capable of Dolby Vision 2, yeah, that kinda stings. And unfortunately, that's technology. Typically, we don't see massive leaps from one year to the very next in TVs like we do with Dolby Vision and what we expect Dolby Vision 2 to look like. But in your case, we don't know yet if Sony will support Dolby Vision 2, though I imagine they will eventually. So if that's your brand of choice, let's wait and see. But if you allow yourself to venture outside of the Sony system, like I said in the last question, at least see what Hisense and TCL's Dolby Vision 2 implementation looks like. And if you do like it, they'll probably have more affordable options with that new format. Thanks for the questions this week, guys. Reminder, send in your questions to youasked@digitaltrends.com for future episodes. We appreciate you watching, and we'll see you in the next video.